Hi guys, welcome back to our channel. MSI is a well-known manufacturer of laptops and PC-related devices, so its power adapter is more suitable for long-term high-power use. And today we will take apart this SMI 100 watts power adapter for a laptop to see why it can continuously output high power. Firstly, tear off the plastic film. The USB-C cable is non-detachable. It adopts a classic black square design, and the matte shell can reduce fingerprints. The SMI is engraved on the top center, and the grounding prong inside the input socket can protect the user from electric shock. The specs info is printed on the bottom, model is A21-100P1A. It can support input of 100-240V, 50-60Hz, 1.6A, and the output can be up to 100W. It also has passed multiple certifications. Here is the other end of the USB-C cable, and there is also a hasp to arrange the cable. The size of the adapter is about 75x75x29mm. The length of the USB-C cable is about 1.55 meters. And the total weight is about 290 grams. Connected to the TrueGen LabPower ZKM00TC, it shows the adapter only supports PD3.0 protocol. And it also supports 4 fixed PDLs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 15V, 3A, and 20V, 5A. After the brief introduction, let's take it apart and check out the internal components. As usual, use a sponge to pry along the gap and open it up. We can see the aluminum sheet and silicon adhesives. Take out the module. The entire module is covered with aluminum heatsink. Remove them. A piece of black Mylar sheet is under it. And those heating components are covered with white silicon adhesives to dissipate heat. After cleaning up the module, we found the input capacitor, PFC bus inductor, transformer around the front of it, and the bridge rectifier, MOSFETs, rectifier, and controller around the back. TrueGenLab found it also adopts PFC circuit plus QR flyback topology. They were controlled by two separate controllers, and the protocol chips controls the output voltage. The input time delay fuse is from Walter Electronic, 3.15A, 300V. The first combo mode choke is wound with magnet and insulated wires, and the safety extra capacitor is from SCC, 0.33 μF. The second combo mode choke is larger than the first one and fixed on the backlight. Those two bridge rectifiers are from Young-J, which can form a half bridge circuit to dissipate the heat evenly. There are two blue film capacitors, 0.68 μF and 1 μF respectively, and the toroidal coil inductor for filtering is between them. The PFC bus controller is from ON Semiconductor, which operates in critical conduction mode. It also adopts the current controlled frequency foldback driving method and has comprehensive protections. And the PFC bus MOSFET is from Vishay, which adopts TO252 package, 650V, 170 mΩ. The PFC bus inductor is wound with lace wire and insulated with copper foil. Those two PFC rectifiers connected in parallel are from Young-J, which are actually ultra-fast recovery diodes, 3A, 600V. The electrolytic capacitor for high-voltage filtering is from Qinsan, 82 μF, 450V. The mass control chip is marked with 6151C and adopts SOT23 package. And the electrolytic capacitor that powers the mass control chip is from Anshi, 100V, 8.2 μF. This MOSFET is from Infineon CoolMOS C7 series, which also adopts TO252 package, 700V, 190 mΩ. The transformer is from Chikney and is insulated with yellow tape. Those two 1009 optocouplers are used to feedback the output voltage and control the PFC circuit, respectively. Here is a blue Y capacitor. The fast turn-off synchronous rectifier controller is from MPS. The synchronous rectifier MOSFET is from ON Semiconductor, controlled by the MPS controller valve, 120V, 8 mΩ. These two solid capacitors are used for output filtering. The larger one is 680 microfarad, 25 volts, and the small one is 560 microfarad, 25 volts. The protocol chip is from Wellchand, which can support USB PD 3.0, QC4, QC4 Plus, and QC5 protocols, and has passed the USB IF certification. Finally, the Apple VBus MOSFET is from Infineon, 30 volts, 1.9 milliohm. Well, that's all components of this MSI 100 watts power adapter. This power adapter is bigger than some GaN chargers. That's because the gap between the components are large and can be filled with adhesives for heat dissipation, so that the peak power can last much longer. And the grounding prong can eliminate the electric shock for metal case laptops. Okay, that's all for today's video. You can click the corners to see other videos for laptop adapters. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!